So Jason, maybe you can introduce yourself and the character you play on Alcatraz.
Sure. I'm Jason Butler Harner, and I play Deputy Warden E.B. Tiller.
And exactly what is his role, considering we see him initially in the past? Is he going to be joining us in the future, or is that
I don't know. That would be amazing. Well, you see my 80-year-old self murdered in the pilot, but I'm pretty much in the 60s.
So you're a 60s guy for this show.
60s, but there's things that I know, and there's things that I'm trying to prevent, and things that I'm trying to make happen.
So is he pulling some strings behind the scenes in the 1963
era? One can only assume. It's a good question between Johnny Coyne, who plays the warden, and I, who's up to what and who's doing the right thing.
Okay, maybe you can
There are issues of gray. There's black and white.
So many mysteries. What drew you to this fascinating role?
What drew me to him?
Yeah.
Well, you know, when you played one bad guy, and then behind every bad guy there is something that either made them bad or that is ultimately good. So that constant revelation is what it keeps me interested in.
So, like, there's a mystery this character I want to know about.
Yeah.
Do you see him as a hero or a villain?
I think at first we'll think he's a villain for a little while.
For a little while. So it's to be decided.
To be decided. But there are definite redeeming qualities to him that will come in early enough.
Well, do you have a lot of opportunity to work with the current cast because you're stuck in 1963?
No, I work with them in the Vancouver bars. we work, most of the stuff is with Johnny and...
somebody you can't talk about yet.
And Prisoners of the Week, and the rest of the time, but the bulk of my time is spent with Sam and Johnny and I, like, walking around the bay in Vancouver.
Do you feel like you're working on two different shows sometimes?
No, I look forward to the chance to be in the modern day and do something to actually act with Sam, especially, because we get along so well.
What can you tease about what's upcoming up that we should pay particular attention to?
I can tease that I have an incredible sister, and I can't wait for my sister's scene, and I can tease... there's some really good reveals coming. That's all I can say. We haven't finished yet, so I don't know the biggest reveals, but I have to say it's so good. It's so tight now. With the extra time we had, it's so clean, and the large story is incredible. Now there's a whole new problem.
What do you think the fans should be most excited about as the show debuts?
Wow. I think the thing that they'll be the most excited about is that not only to have Jorge back, you know, I think when you say the fans, you sort of go to Lost a little bit, but and then you have Sam, who's from another world. I think the thing to be most excited about is that you have these two worlds, and right now it seems like there's a lot of shows that have different time periods in them. The great thing about our show is that the two really work together very well. Do you know what I mean? It's going back and forth, not completely in one, it's a tease, and there's a relation of past and present that seems to show us something about ourselves. This is the guy you have to talk to.
I know.